Coming up, we are going to talk about how you can bring modern DevOps technique to actually deploy and manage your applications running on Kubernetes clusters in your hybrid and multi-cloud environments using Azure Arc. I'm here with Jason Hansen, Program Manager from the Azure Arc team. Hi, Jason.
Hey, Thomas. Really happy to join you today.
So, Jason, we are here to talk about Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes clusters and how you can use that to manage applications on top of that. But first, we have different organizations and customers running Kubernetes clusters in Azure, on-premises, and in multi-cloud environment. How can Azure Arc actually help us or help our customers with that?
Yeah, that's a great question. And so our customers are running applications, infrastructure in lots of different locations. You know, it could be on-prem investments in your existing data centers. It could be managed service providers, you know, working with the ISV or systems integrator, as well as running applications and infrastructure on multiple clouds. Now, what we want to do with Azure Arc is unlock the power of the Azure platform and all of our management services, and really extend those capabilities into those non-Azure locations. And what that looks like for a cluster operator, Kubernetes, means you can register your Kubernetes clusters with the Azure platform by deploying an agent. It runs as a container in the Azure Arc namespace, and those agents call into the Azure platform. They establish a secure relationship with Azure and allow you to see your Kubernetes cluster in the Azure portal. That cluster gets an MSI, a managed server identity. It gets an Azure Resource Manager ID, and as such can participate in the economy of Azure services. And by that, I mean you can unlock capabilities like Azure Monitor for containers, Azure Policy for Kubernetes, or Azure Defender for Kubernetes, really a lot giving you kind of full management capacity from Azure to your Kubernetes clusters, no matter where they happen to be running.
So that means actually, I can add Kubernetes clusters which are running outside of Azure, and they kind of become a native Azure resource, and I can use the same management tools for all my clusters independently where they're actually running. So this is great stuff. Now, what does this actually mean? So if I'm like I spoke a lot to cloud architects, and if I'm a cloud architect, how can I take leverage of that?
Yeah, that's a great question. And I've got a little demo here, kind of in two parts. The first is we'll walk through what it looks like to connect a cluster to Azure. And then second, you know, once this cluster is connected, you know, I've got clusters spread all over. How can I use Azure Arc enabled Kubernetes to uniformly gain access to those clusters to, say, interactively troubleshoot or debug an issue? So let's go ahead and dig in. All right. So starting from the Azure portal, I'm going to go ahead and navigate to the Azure Arc Center. I'm going to add infrastructure and select Kubernetes as my form factor. Now, by answering a few questions, selecting my subscription and a resource group, and giving this cluster a name and picking a region, we're getting ready to tell, you know, the Azure platform where this cluster is coming. Now, as an Azure resource, I can also use tags, and the platform generates a script around that using the Azure CLI to onboard. Now, I'm going to go ahead and switch to my terminal. I've got local access to this Kubernetes cluster, and I'm going to use the Azure CLI to go ahead and onboard. Now, by running az connected kates connect, the CLI command accesses the local cluster, accesses Azure, and then deploys the agent connecting the two pieces together. Now, as this agent starts, it's running as a standard Kubernetes workload. So it's an operator in the Azure Arc namespace. And as a Kubernetes developer or a cluster administrator, I can use all of my existing tooling to interact with this agent. So it should feel very Kubernetes native. Now, this connection has been established and the cluster is up in the portal. And in the portal, we can see the name and basic metadata about the cluster.
Now, you mentioned that there's obviously more to it, what I can do now with that cluster, right?
Yeah, exactly. And now that the cluster is attached, if I want to be able to request access to that API server, you know, since I've got clusters everywhere under different networking configurations, it can be really difficult to access the cluster and use those native Kubernetes tools. So we have a feature in the platform called Cluster Connect. And what this allows you to do is to use Azure role-based access control and Azure Active Directory to allow your operators or your developers to access the API server. In doing so, you can request a secure connection. It's authenticated again using Azure Active Directory, and the transport to that cluster is carried over Azure Hybrid Connections, ensuring that you've got a secure end-to-end connection. So let's go ahead and see what that looks like. Now, I'm in my console and I'm running AZ ConnectedKate's proxy, which sets up the proxy, again, authenticated through Azure Active Directory. And in the top of my terminal, I'm using standard Kubernetes tools to access the clusters. So listing cluster information, navigating and listing the resources. And the nice thing about this is that since we're using standard Kubernetes mechanisms, any tool that uses a kubeconfig can work. And so here we're using K9s, which is an interactive tool to navigate and troubleshoot any Kubernetes cluster. And I'm going through the Azure Arc namespace and looking at the workloads that are deployed as part of the agent. And this is a great building block, you know, for native access, but can also compose on top of other CI/CD pipelines that you might have, or other troubleshooting, monitoring, and debugging tools that you have in your broader Kubernetes ecosystem.
Okay, this is pretty cool, because this will obviously make a lot of IT pros and developers very happy that I can actually use these tools and I can actually take advantage of the Azure control plane and Azure Active Directory to get that role-based access and using that proxy to actually run commands on these clusters without needing to think about like network connectivity, like VPNs and stuff like that. So this is awesome. So speaking of developers, one thing which also is one of the challenges we see often is now, I obviously want to deploy applications to these Kubernetes clusters. And again, they can run in multiple places. They can run at retail stores, branch offices, and so on. So this can also make it very tough for me to actually like deploy these applications to all of these clusters. Can Azure Arc help me with that as well?
Yeah, that's a great question. And I think you've really nailed one of the challenges that customers have as they continue to scale their infrastructure. And that's really, you know, I've got lots of these things running in lots of different locations. How do I make sure everything is up to date and configured appropriately? And really with Arc, there are two pieces that we can really pull on. One is that we can use a GitOps-based workflow to take configuration from our cluster operators and application configuration from our development teams, and apply that configuration to 1, 10, or even hundreds of Kubernetes clusters. The GitOps workflow makes sure that those clusters are kept up to date, and our developers and our cluster operations teams, you know, use a Git-based workflow to add, update, or delete resources from those clusters. Now, we can pair that with Azure Policy, and the power that comes from this is that we can use the Azure Policy framework to say, all right, I want my infrastructure in these subscriptions or these resource groups to always have these applications deployed or to always have these cluster configurations applied. And Azure Policy will monitor the entirety of our infrastructure by policy to ensure that everything is kept up to date. And so what that means is as a cluster, you know, registers with the platform or deregisters with the platform, or as those policies change over time, we can get a single place to go view that all of my clusters are configured appropriately. And if any of those clusters should drift, either by configuration, GitOps will repair that cluster, or by policy, Azure Policy will alert and can drive remediation activities, all again from Azure.
I love how we can actually combine it with our native Azure capabilities and then connect resources wherever they are running. Can you show me that in a quick demo?
Yeah, let's go ahead and dig in now that we kind of understand very high level what GitOps and policy are doing. Let's go ahead and start in the portal here. And I've got a cluster that we have attached to the platform. We're going to go ahead and navigate to the GitOps section for this cluster on the left-hand side. You can see GitOps. And here that we can see that I've got two configurations attached to this cluster. One for a security baseline, which is across the whole cluster, and a second configuration, a team application here, which is focused just on my application team and dedicated to or deployed to a specific namespace. Now, Let's go ahead and take a look at what this Git repo looks like for this specific configuration. Here we're in GitHub, and we've got a repository with all of the resources that we need for our application. And in this case, it's pretty simple. It's a service and a deployment. And as you can see, it's standard Kubernetes manifest material that lives in this repository. Any valid Kubernetes resource can be deployed by our GitOps system. As well, since this is a Git-based workflow, if I want to change or update something, like for example, bump an application version, my team does it by opening a pull request. Now, the power of this means that I can also back this pull request with GitHub Actions, for example, where I can check the validity of the manifests, or I can assert, you know, business logic in terms of, you know, CI testing and rollout. As well, the conversation around this pull request can all be tracked here in Git. So let's go ahead and take a look at this application as deployed in my Kubernetes cluster, and we'll go ahead and merge the pull request. Now, this pull request is merging, and the GitOps system deployed to all of our clusters are monitoring this repo for change. And once the change is detected, configuration will be updated in the cluster. And here we can watch the application roll out to the latest version. Now, the power of this is that it's not just one cluster, but it can be 10 or hundreds, meaning that the configuration is staged, tested, and when merged, begins rollout across my infrastructure. And there are lots of knobs and dials and handles that you can pull on in terms of how you structure that rollout for safe deployment in terms of you know, regions, rings, repos, branches, a lot of flexibility here, which means we can generally tackle any of your business requirements around a deployment pipeline and workflow. Now, from an at scale scenario, you know, coming to the portal and configuring all of these configurations manually is probably going to, you know, let a few slip through the cracks. So as I mentioned before, let's use the Azure policy framework to define what I want my clusters to look like. So here we've got a policy that says, hey, any cluster that's attached to my infrastructure needs to be running that baseline secure configuration. And we can assign an additional policy for that team-based application by navigating, selecting the appropriate policy and configuring it appropriately. Again, this config and all of these requirements are given to the Azure policy platform. As clusters come and clusters go, the Azure policy engine will kick in and deploy the applications and configuration. Or if those applications and configurations are removed, alert and allow cluster operators and owners to remediate. Again, giving you a single pane of glass to make sure that all of your stuff is kept up to date.
Okay, so this is super awesome, especially if I need to manage like clusters at a certain scale. But also, like, I mean, even if I have a small amount of clusters, I can still take advantage of this to actually manage all of that. I like the way we can actually go in and not just apply like the GitOps, like the policy for the cluster configuration, but then actually use Azure policy to make sure that they're actually assigned. So whenever I join a new cluster, it automatically goes into that configuration. It automatically gets all the application configurations and so on. And then I guess like as soon as I remove a cluster, obviously this is just gone. Really, really cool stuff. Now, for me, obviously, I want to learn more about this. So where can I find more about that?
Yes, great question. And so we have a number of resources to help folks get started. I would say the first place to start is our documentation site. So Azure Arc Enabled Kubernetes Doctree has a number of quick starts, concepts, guides to get you started. The second is the Azure Arc Jumpstart repository. And this is really focused at folks who want to get up and running very quickly with the demo environment so they can kick the tires. And we've got a number of scenarios documented there, including stuff like Terraform scripts that allow you to, you know, help you provision a cluster and again, attach it to Azure. Last but not least, we have the MS Learn modules that really take you from zero to hero to get, you know, additional knowledge in this area.
Okay, this is awesome. Thank you very much, Jason. And for you watching, if you want to learn more about hybrid and multi-cloud architectures, check out our Cloud Adoption Framework and the Azure Architecture Center.